So hole number one out here is a dogleg left par four. You just want to hit it out the middle about 230 and then play it left straight into the green. So I have a hybrid. Second shot, it came up a little bit short here, so I'm just going to try to pitch this inside 3 foot and get up and out the park. Work. Okay, pause it. There's it.
All I'm left here was a little tap in, so go ahead and tap it in.
Nice up and down for a par. So, second hole, straight away par 3, 183 yards up the hill. I'm gonna go with a 6-iron. Should be good. I missed the green slightly right, pin high, breaking a little bit right to left. Try to make it. If only I hit the ball. Pause it. Out here is a par 5 across the front of the tee shot and then straight uphill to a 3-tier green. So I'm just going to try to put something in play. That's my goal. Straight down the middle. Does work.
Okay.
After that drive, I have 186 yards to a very back pin on a 3-2 green, all uphill, into wind. I'm gonna hit a 4-iron and just try to get it back there. Out to the right a little bit, we'll have to chip and hopefully get up and down for birdie. So after my second shot, I missed it a little right, came up short, got about a 40 yard pitch and I cannot be short, so I'm going to try to play a little right and a little left. So I have a quick downhiller now, about 3.5-4 foot. It'd be tough, but I need to make it to par. And I pulled it. Oh boy, I hate bogey and par fives. Not good. Hole number 4 here, the par 4, going straight out and dog legs to the right. But I am going to take a risky play and try to cut the corner a little bit, so we'll see what happens. standing off. I have like a 20-yard chip, the flag. I'm just gonna try to put it next to the hole and make a par. Breaking a little to my right. Try to make my par. But I never gave it a chance. That's okay. I'll tap this in, make my bogey, and make a birdie on the next one. That's a bogey. Number 5 is a par 5. Goes straight out, goes a little to the right. Straight uphill in your second shot to a downhill slope. So just try to blast one and get it somewhere close enough to where I can go for it. See what I can do. All in the wind by that. I missed my drive a little left here. Now I have like 270 in, all uphill, a little in the wind. I'm just gonna try to get me something over the top of the hill and leave myself like 100 yards. So I'm gonna hit a 6-iron and just try to place it. Should be good. After a really well-placed second shot, I have 107 yards left in to a back to front slipping green. I'm gonna take a gap wedge and knock it down and just try to put it a little right of the hole. Put it a little short right of the hole, should have an uphill putt. I have about a 30 footer here uphill. It's gonna break a little to my left, possibly. I'm just gonna try to put it close and make my par. I pulled that putt really bad. But let's see if I can just tap in for a.
I'm gonna try to tap in for my par.
Save a par. Hole number 6 is yet another par 5. The plays off this tee box is to take a driver over the edge right here and we'll draw, or take a 3-wood at that bunker and draw it off. I'm gonna play a little more aggressive and try to play a little straighter and try to get down there and reach the green too. So after that drive, I have 215 left in. I'm just gonna try to put something near the front right bunker, and it's all downwind, so I'm probably gonna try to get there. Be good. Just right in front. Okay, I left myself right here, just left of the bunker, just short of the green. I'm just going to try to chip it right next to the hole, make a birdie. That ran about 7 or 8 foot past. I have a putt coming back down the hill for birdie.
So I have this about 8 foot down the hill, breaking to my left. It's gonna be a little quick. I'll try to make it, get me a shot back, make a birdie. Just slip by the hole.
I'm gonna go ahead and tap this in for par.
Just stay at 2 over.
Okay, number 7 out here is a par 3 over a pond with a bunker to the right. You do not want to miss left, so I will try my best not to miss left. And it's 182 yards downhill. I got a 7-iron.
Sorry for the cut right here, guys. I had to go back to my bag and grab a 6-iron because the wind started blowing in my face and I just wanted enough club to get there.
First shot on number 7 here, I ended up on the front left of the green. I have a uphill putt about 25-30 feet breaking to my right. Just try to put it close and save another par. I guess that should be an easy par. Safely in for the par.
Hole number 8 out here is a par 4. Normally drivable, but today it's in the wind. Straight up this huge hill, and then when you hit your drive, you'll have a little uphill shot. I'm just gonna take a 3-wood and try to put it in the middle of the fairway. I don't think I've ever hit a straighter ball in my life. That should be perfect.
Oh.
So after my drive here on the normally drivable par 4, I have 65 yards left to the flag. I'm just going to smooth 60. Should be front edge.
I've got about a 20 footer here up the hill, breaking to my left. Just try to put it close and make another par. That's not a gimme.
Okay, I got about a 4 footer here, breaking to my right, down the hill. Try to make it like half a par. After getting a lucky bounce onto the front, I have like a 25-30 footer breaking to my left up the hill for birdie. Let's make it to finish off. Get in. Get in. Oh, so close.